Back to the Pilatus factory. Today we're going to test fly a brand new PC-12 model, the PC-12 Pro.
So good morning, my name is Patrick. I'm a test pilot at Pilatus Aircraft, and I've had the privilege to be the project pilot for the new PC-12 Pro project, where we integrated a brand new latest generation of Garmin's avionics and integrated Garmin flight deck. So Garmin's new integrated flight deck consists of three 14-inch displays, which are all touchscreen. You can interact with any of the screens with touch. So we've got three PDUs and then two SDUs. Everything is touch, very easy to use and interactive. And Garmin have designed this system to have a short time for each task to complete to make sure that it's intuitive and easy to use for low hour and even professional pilots.
I noticed the yoke is also slightly different now. It has the same PC-24 yoke. So Patrick, is this actually our flight plan? So we take off 2-4 and then go through a couple waypoint here, Gersa, and then waypoint 0, 1, 2, 3. I believe those are sightseeing through the mountains. And then our destination is Samedan.
Correct, yeah. So we're going to take off IFR to get on top of the fog. As soon as you're on top of the fog, we can do a shortcut and start going back to the east. And then we'll just follow these points that I put in with graphical flight planning, doing a scenic flight through the mountains all the way to Samedan.
It's starting. The start is on. Ignition is on. We got the four greens. Light up at 19%. Now comes a very special part from Switzerland where we have to taxi over a few roads.
Yeah.
And activate traffic light systems. So we have a red light, clear left, clear right.
And look at the graphic screen, it really resembles what I see here, what I see in real. Like the gate is coming and you can see it.
And this is the safe taxi feature. So on the synthetic vision, you see the taxiways here. On any map, you see all the taxiways, the numbers, to give you a good idea of where you are. So the car on the left is stopping. The car on the right is going quite quickly. He's going through, unfortunately. So you have to look
light.
On the right, he's stopping. That's good. On the left,
okay.
It's good. We cleared.
He was in a hurry, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, car give way to the plane. Thank you.
So we have these very nice thing called the display presets, which helps people to set up the display because there's so many options. So we have a takeoff IFR display preset. So when I push that, it will configure all the displays for what we need. So we have our chart, we have our map, we have a traffic map on the right hand side. We have the turf VNAV here and we have the flight plan down here. So.
There's Sierra Golf. Freeport established in Brown Zulu, Charlie 601, wind 25, 30 degrees 6 knots, runway 24, clear for takeoff.
Freeport established in Brown Zulu, Charlie 601, clear takeoff, runway 24, auto Sierra Golf. Coming up to takeoff power, we see takeoff up on the EIS. We check we have full power. So 50, torque is good, engine parameters are in the grip at 70. Then 82, we're going to slowly pull back and rotate. Aircraft is flying. We put the white attitude into the purple bars. Then positive rate gear comes up.
Gear up.
Your damper comes on. And above 100, we bring up the flaps. And soon, then we will come on top and see the sun again. There we go.
Beautiful.
Welcome to
Look
our playground,
that.
Yeah. The Sierra Golf is now on top and turning right, canceling IFR. So the first thing I want to show you is just the terrain. So you have this terrain overlay that you can bring up, which is very useful. It shows anything that's at your altitude or above is red, and anything at your altitude or just below you is brownish green, basically. So with one look, you can see where the terrain is and where you should avoid.
Terrain ahead.
So you see.
Terrain ahead.
And then you see even on the synthetic vision on
terrain
the map,
ahead.
It gives you an idea of
terrain
where
ahead.
The impact
Caution,
could be.
Caution, terrain. Caution, terrain.
And then you can
Caution,
turn
terrain.
Away.
Caution, terrain.
On the top of this mountain is a restaurant, so we'll go and have a look at that quickly.
Yeah.
Just to show you how Swiss people go to lunch.
Oh, wow. What a restaurant at the top of the hill. Ooh, we're passing you.
We have a data link weather, so up here I can bring up the data link weather page. There we can then activate, it tells you the sources connect, so it's using SATCOM or VHF. And there you see all the options of the things we can display. And yeah, we will go in here, we will request all the different products.
Oh wow.
All the different options.
So much information here.
And then say we want to request it every 15 minutes and send an immediate request. And Garmin have introduced sort of some clever logic into the frequency tab. So if I click on the frequency, I can go and it will tell me these are the things it thinks I need for the next phase of flight. So it's telling me the ATIS frequency for Samedan is this. So just with one press, I can put that there and I can put it into the standby or into the active frequency.
I never have to look it up again.
Yeah.
You know, I just love all this simple system touchscreen. It's really for low hour pilots.
Exactly.
Like, yeah. It reduced my workload so much.
Yeah.
And it's anticipated all the days, help me to navigate better.
So if I want to change my route, I can just press on the leg I want to change. I can move it to wherever I want to, so even to a waypoint if I want to. And then just execute, and then I've changed my route just with touch, with just a single touch.
That's amazing.
We have this radial menu or donut. It's a dynamic function, so wherever I put it over, it's showing me airspace or waypoint or an airport. If I want to find out the weather at my airport or the frequencies, I can just put it on there. Click on the airport tab. I can get information. I can view procedures, charts, get a directly tune frequencies into the COM1 or COM2, get the weather from the data link. I can open that up and see. So I can see the QNH is 1031. So I can already adjust. I can see it's CAV okay, -17, so quite cold. Okay, so what we're going to do is simulate. We're going to descend down to 8,000 feet. So I said 8,000 feet. I'm going to disengage the auto throttle because I want to show you how it would be, would react for you if it wasn't engaged. And then as soon as the auto throttle detects that this trend, the 6 second trend is going into the red, it will then add power and then engage the auto throttle. So speed's reducing. As it hits then the speed 5 knots below the DSP and it picks up a trend, it will then engage the auto throttle. There
engaging
it comes.
Auto throttle.
Auto throttle's up.
Yeah.
And then auto throttle.
Add some power to make sure that we are staying at a safe speed. And if you want to, you can maybe fly a little bit now.
I'm going to fly a little
bit. I'll switch off. And what we can show you is the roll ESP.
Okay.
So if you see these double bars here?
Mm-hmm.
So if you reach that, then the roll ESP will roll you back. So if you reach 51 degrees, it rolls.
You sure?
Yeah. You can roll to the left.
Okay. I'm going to roll to the left, 51 degrees.
Perfect. And then you'll see the double bars move. You'll feel the force rolling you back to level. A little bit more.
A little bit more?
ESP is engaged. You feel it's rolling us back.
Oh, I felt the G's coming back. Oh.
And then you see you come back to a stable, nice position.
So it won't make you to roll more than 51 degrees, really?
Yeah, it wants you, I mean, a normal normal maximum bank for this type of airplane is 45 for a steep turn. You see the double bars and how they move, and you feel how smooth it is. So
yep.
It's a very smooth input, just like your friendly flight instructor saying, hey, you have a bit too much bank, I'm going to help you roll it back.
Roger.
To level flight.
We're in the beautiful Samedan area. There's a helicopter ahead of us will meet us and they will film us while we are landing in Samedan.
Gears down, flaps are 40, cabin pressure below 0.7, and the yaw damp is coming off. We're on the green speed, lining up on center line. Three reds, speed coming down.
100.
Try to get
50,
to center line.
40. 30. 20.
Information echo, flutter 170 with a second spot of formation. Call you and below, flutter 130.
This flight is really showing Switzerland is at its best. We're the best weather, best test pilots, and the latest PC-12 Pro. It makes flying a pleasure. I can't say anything more because it was a feeling that is difficult to explain, but it just makes things look so easily done. So after a hot chocolate at the airport, I'm back on board doing our last sector from St. Moritz here, Samedan, to Zurich International Airport. Now, this is gonna be a cool one, landing in a big international airport, but we can do exactly all the big planes do.
We also have this auto land feature, which will automatically land the aeroplane in case of a pilot incapacitation. You can start it by pushing the button, or if the pilot is by himself and hasn't interacted with the system for up to 30 minutes, it will automatically enter auto land. And then it will automatically decide according to the performance, the data link weather, the available terrain, which airport would be the most suitable, and then descend, fly and approach, and land the airplane, and eventually shut down. So when loading an approach, I wanted to load the ILS-1A14. It asked me what the minimums are, so just by pressing this linked view, I can bring up the approach here, and then I can bring up the chart. I can then scroll to the bottom, get the minimum, and then type it in without having to go to my chart application and doing all sorts of fact finding.
Which is 1602, the minimum.
Yeah, and then it will, when I've loaded it, it'll appear here on the PFD to show my barometer.
It shows here.
During target A, Hotel Bravo Foxtrot Sierra Golf is 4 miles final on 14.
Clear to land, runway 14 at the circle. 3 miles,
speed is checked, gears coming down. See three hatches. Coming underneath the clouds, looking for the runway. Gears down, three greens, flaps 15, cabin pressure is below 0.7, automation still engaged, going out of push ice mode. See how the autopilot puts us perfectly on final?
Yeah.
Can't ask for more than that. The auto throttle's coming off. 100 feet to minima. You'll hear it say approaching minimums.
Approaching minimums.
And then minimums.
Minimums.
Oh, disconnecting. Gears down, flaps are 15, trims are all good, cabin pressure and
100.
For the center line.
50. 40.
Lots of energy.
30.
Flaps 15.
20. 10.
And then slowly back to idle. And we'll just keep the speed up so we can exit. The exit is right there at the end. So.
Well done.
Well done to you.
Thank you, Patrick.
Pleasure.
Yeah, what a pleasure flying on the PC-12 Pro, man. It's so easy
for
low-hour
pilots.
Landing in Zurich. Thank you so much.
Done, yeah.
Yeah.